I don't want to be honey, and I don't want to be vinegar, and I don't want to come across as salty. So how do I discuss hot button issues like diversity without coming across as sugarcoating or being acrid? I'm author Gwen Alyce Clayton. I'm a disabled pagan woman with a degree in public administration. My goal with the Rivervine YouTube channel is to have a smooth running mainstream where all drivers and vehicles participate freely and equally. Instead of having the honey and vinegar analogy, I rather liken it to 87 octane gasoline. You don't need the fancy high-octane petrol to get your vehicle moving on the road. What you need is fuel. Every person is a vehicle, a unique vehicle, a unique make and model. And every vehicle wants to participate in the mainstream of traffic. Some vehicles are white, others are black. Some are vintage, others just drove off the showroom floor. Some have the little Christian fish symbol on their windows. Others have the coexist sticker on their bumper. Some have disabled person license plates, while others are maybe from a different state or country. As long as the vehicle is in operable order and the driver knows how to operate it, they have a right to participate in the mainstream of traffic. The problem, though, is getting onto the freeway from the on-ramp. If the cars already in traffic don't let you in, you could end up in the breakdown lane, slowing down, making it even harder to get into traffic once the opportunity does come. Or if you're on a cloverleaf freeway, you could end up going back the way you came from. The U.S. population is increasing. As more people are born in this country and medical advances allow us to survive until later in life, maybe with disabilities though, and as more people immigrate here from other countries, the population is obviously going to diversify. And every one of us wants to be able to live life as we truly are, as our unique identities, whatever that may be, whether that's race, religion, gender, sexual orientation, ability, disability, neurotypical, anything, whatever the case may be, we need to see each other as individuals, beautiful individuals, and we need to be able to celebrate our uniqueness and help each other when we need help. And we need to be able to let others into the mainstream. Success breeds success, and like attracts like. So we're more prone to help others who are like us. We naturally gravitate toward others who are like us. And we also have natural biases against people who are different from us. If they look different, if they believe different, if they act different. And especially when it comes to our own personal values, when people are different, we see this a lot with religion and with cultural norms. It's like, oh my gosh, my religion, something is an abomination, but in other religions, it isn't. So you have to understand that people have different political views, different religious views, different values, different family structures. And just because they're different doesn't mean they're wrong. And we need to be able to reach out to people who aren't like us, people who don't look like us, people who don't believe like us, people who don't pray like us, or live like us in the same family structure. We need to be able to reach out to everyone to give them the fuel that they need. My husband and I like to watch videos from Hillsdale College. I have very diverse political opinions. My husband leans right. Okay, he's conservative. Let's admit that. So, and I do enjoy listening to certain conservative speakers. Not all of them, but some of them. But when I look at Hillsdale's YouTube channel, most of their speakers are white men. They have a few white women, but the only speakers of color that they have are ones who want to speak about racial issues. And they always take the conservative side of racial issues. I really wish Hillsdale College would invite more speakers of color to talk about things other than racial issues. And another thing is they have, what is her name? Heather McDonald has written a book about the diversity delusion, how race and gender pandering corrupt the university and undermine our culture. So I've heard her speech many times. Anti-diversity program. She claims to be pro diversity. You just don't need to have a program about it. We don't need to hire additional administrators and additional staff, and we don't need training materials. We don't need to have a program for diversity. It should just be everyone being judged on the content of their character, which again would be great if that's how it worked in real life. But she also goes on to argue that she's thankful that she went to Yale at a time when she was able to study the classics, which again, it's great that you get to study the classics, but who were the classic authors? They were white men. And she argues that if she had to go to school today, she'd have to study women authors and artists of color and all this other stuff. And she makes it sound like women or people of color or anybody who's not a white male isn't capable of doing quality work. And that isn't true. So if we want to show that we don't need diversity, that we truly are judging people on the content of our characters, I would expect that to show up in their choices of videos that they upload, the speakers that they invite to speak. So yeah, let's have a little more diversity based on the content of your character, but that also resembles all the different diverse groups that are claiming don't get adequate representation. Let's do that. If you liked this video, please be sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. I post videos every Tuesday evening. And if you would like to support my work, you can support me on Patreon at patreon.com/rivervine. And if you are interested in my books, Fermata Sellers and Zinfandel's Grimoire, you can find them on Amazon. And my website address is gwenclaytonwrites.com. I'll see you next Tuesday. Thank you for watching.